What did I just say? No bouncing. Can you come sit down, please?
Because Ryan is a rabbit.
Yeah. No, no. Hello, Mr. Eric. Hello, Mr. Ryan.
Hello.
Hello.
Mr. Teacher.
Okay. Remember, what is Q?
First in, first out.
Yes.
Back.
So today we'll talk about another type of queue. Remember, another queue, we talk about priority queue, yeah? Yeah? First in...
Priority
out, okay. So today we'll talk about another queue, which is called double-ended queue.
Double-ended.
So what does it mean, double-ended? So it means that a queue has to...
Double down.
So you can push to the both sides, right? Remember, first... So look, this is a queue, yeah? First in, first out. So look, if you want to dequeue, we call it dequeue. The normal queue, just take it from the head, right? Mm-hmm. And then when you want to in queue, we call it in queue. Yeah, enter element to the queue. We push. We start from this side, right? This is called normal queue. For this double ended queue, is what happened is that you can specify. You can specify both sides. So you can say, okay, I want to push from this side, or I can push to this side, or I can take an element from the head, or take an element from the rear. So it basically has two sides open. So you can specify which side you want to push or pop the element. But for the normal queue, you can only push to the rear of the queue and pop from the beginning of the queue, right?
Yes.
Yeah. So in Python, we can do this from collection. Okay, collection is a module. Import what? Dequeue. Dequeue. Okay, that means double ended queue. Okay.
Yeah.
And
out.
Look, you can say queue. You can look dequeue, right?
Yeah.
And then you can say queue dot append.
Equals
append and append one, so now the queue will be one, okay? Q dot append two, so what happened? So now one will become 1, 2, so it append to the rear, okay? How about Q dot append left? There is a function called append left. Three, what happened? So now is append left 3, so what was
23.
That?
23.
No, append left, it will be 3, 1, 2. Okay?
Yeah.
And then this append and append left. Obvious, and apparently we have q.pop. So if q.pop, what happened? Pop is pop from the back. So you'll be 3, 1. And then this function will return 2, right? Or q.pop left. So what's the value?
1.
q.pop left?
1.
3. Left. You see, append left, pop left is all talking about the left side. So it's 3 and then it will become 1. Okay? Yeah? So this is append and
you
pop left.
One.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, so today. So this is very important. So today, we talk about a problem using this double ended queue. Remember, we talk about breakfast search. Okay, so I give it a 3.
Wow.
1.
2, 3.
3.
4, 5.
4.
5.
Okay, 5. Six. So design an algorithm to compute the sum of all nodes in the binary tree. So what's the answer?
15.
Wow, that's 15. Yes. So how do we do it?
Easy.
Remember, we talk about this breakfast search.
Breakfast. That makes me hungry.
Breakfast search. Remember? So this breakfast search, what happened is that how do we remember?
Ow.
Breakfast search, we have a queue, right? Then we push the elements of the root to the queue, and then we pop out the queue, and one element from the queue, and then push each kid to the queue, right?
Yeah.
Right. So can we write it?
Two rabbits.
Okay.
Why do you use that one, not that one?
That's okay. Oh, let's use this one. Wait, come here. You must remember. Look, define breakfast search, okay? And then let's take a root.
Come on!
Come on.
We can just all skip through this.
Answer equals 0, okay?
Yeah.
So this is the sum we are going to do. Somewhere at the end, we are going to return.
Yeah.
answer, yeah?
You're gonna write that much.
Yeah, normally. Okay, so like we have a DQ, right? Q equals DQ.
Yes.
Okay, Ryan, come here. Ryan, you're on YouTube, please.
Hey.
Okay, so we are now have a Q. What should we do with the Q? We need to... What? No, not yet. If the root is empty, okay? If the root we forgot is none, we return 0, yeah?
Yeah.
Q dot append root, right?
Yeah.
Now the Q have a root. Then Y length Q is bigger than 0, yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah? What?
While
so this means that when there's an element still in the queue, remember we take one element.
P.
We take one from the queue, which is let's call it P. Equals what?
Q
dot what? Dot what?
Pop
what?
Left.
Pop left. Because we're taking the beginning. Pop left. Remember, pop left is the same as the pop 0 and when we use the list, right?
Yeah.
Wait, look. A if it is the list, right?
Yeah.
And A dot pop 0 is the same as DQ dot pop left. But the complexity, pop left is O1 constant, but pop 0 in the worst case is On. So that's why we use the double end DQ, because it's more efficient than this pop 0. Do you get it?
Yeah.
Okay. So now, is the video still running?
Yeah.
Okay. So now we take one element and we need to add the value to the answer, yeah? Answer plus equals P dot value, right? Right?
Yeah.
Alright? Then we need to push its kids to the queue, right? So what? If P dot left, then we push Q dot what? Append left or append right? Append. Append, yeah, put it in the back, yeah, P dot left. If P dot right, what happened here?
Return.
Not yet, look, Q dot what? We need
append.
To push, append, yeah, append what?
Append P.
P dot what?
Right.
Yes, we're pushing it right key to the end, yeah? Okay, we're running
return
out of
answer. Window.
Yeah, we got that. Okay, so this is the breakfast search. Remember, you learned this before, okay?
Breakfast search.
You learned from us.
Breakfast.
This is breakfast search, but breakfast search we talk about that. We talk about that before, but today we only focus on this. Okay. Okay, so we do the coding part. Let's right? Turn on, please.
Turn on.
Can you be, please be quiet, please?
Ouch!
Eh?
You're not facing the right way.
Wait.
Let's try it.
Wait. Okay, please.
Please.
Can you be a good boy, please? I take this away, okay. Sorry.
Didn't hurt.
Okay, can you sit down? No jumping, please. If you keep jumping, what happened?
What? The camera will fly off.
Yeah. I think this is okay, yeah? This
really?
Is okay.
Really?
Let's
really?
Do the BFS
really?
Dot py, okay? Can you not be... Can you sit down, please?
I'm going to turn off this so it's more, it's clear, yeah?
Yeah, I think this is okay.
Let me see.
No, not seeing. Okay, that's okay. I is it clear, yeah?
Yeah.
I think it's clear, yeah? Okay?
Yeah, Papa.
Let's write something, yeah?
Yeah, Papa.
Yeah, okay. So now, the beginning, what should we do? From collections, import the DQ object, right? DQ object, right?
Mm-hmm.
This is the double ended queue. So now, if we can do it, compute the sum, okay? Sum of 3, and we given a root, okay?
That's 0f, not of.
Sum of, yeah, let's of. If root is none, what? Return?
None. wait.
Zero is fine. Okay, then Q equals DQ, right? Right?
Yeah.
Q dot what?
Pop.
Append.
Free.
Root. Y len cube what? Is bigger than zero, right? P equals what?
Q
dot what? Pop left. Then we need to add the answer. Answer plus P value, right? And we are missing the answer here. Right? Then we need to check if left try or right try, right? Yeah?
Yeah.
P left. All
of the zeros are burning.
So what? Q dot what?
Google time.
That's okay. I'm right?
Yeah.
Q dot append what?
Root. P.
Append. P dot right. Come on, you need to understand, okay? Return what?
Answer.
Okay.
Ooh,
so this is now we let's test yeah. it, okay? Let's test this a little bit. So let's do this. Class. Tree, node, okay, class node. Define int self value left equals none, right equals none, okay? Self dot value equals value. Self dot left equals left. Self dot right equals right. Okay, now let's do define add left triad. Add a triad, okay? Add triad. Self left triad. Left triad. Right triad. Okay? So now let's say that left triad. Self to left let's do this easy way to left one add one triad at a time. So let add the left triad which we call it a value and set let's do it new node equals node value and we are given a node now and then self dot left equals new node return new node okay and then let's do this add right triad self dot value the same. New node equals equals node value self dot right equals new node return what
answer.
There is no answer. Oh, don't always guess. Okay, new node. Yes,
new node.
Left triad. Anyway, you need to understand, not just guessing all the time. Okay, now let's create a root. Okay, root, remember root is node one, right? And then let's do it.
Root
dot add left triad. Let's add a left triad, which is 2. Okay, and then let's go root dot add right triad. Triad 3. Okay, now we have right.
We have
right dot add left triad 4.
Yeah,
and right dot add left triad 5. Right.
Now
let's do this. Print sum of tree root. So you should give me 15, right? Am I right?
Yes, that's easy.
8. Oh, 11. That's not right. Let's do this.
Oh.
Sum answer p value p y. This should be all right. This append.
Yes.
Append to the back and then pop to the left. So there must be something wrong with this. With this triad adding. Node equals node 1. When we add the left triad, new node, okay? When we add the right triad, new node. So right equals root dot add the right triad, 3. And then we can do the, okay. Right dot add left, add right triad. Look, remember. This is add right try, not left try. Okay? It's give me 15. Okay? Got it? Yes? Let's take a look at this code again. So, sum of tree,
if the root is none, we return nothing. We create a double empty queue. We push the root to the queue. The answer is the number we are looking for, going to calculate. Why there's an item in a queue, we take the first item, the front of the queue, we add the value to the sum. Then, if there's a left child, we push it to the back of the queue. If there's a right child, we push the child to the back right queue, yeah? Okay? Note, this is define the tree, and we add the left child, we add the right child. And then this is the tree we are talking about. 1, the left child is 2, the right child is 3. The left child of 3 is 4, the right child of 3 is 5. And we compute the sum of the tree, which is 15. Got it? Okay, so let's take another look at the double empty queue. Look, from collections, import, DQ, okay? So you need to tell me what is the queue, the content, okay? Let's take, what's the, let's create a queue. So what's the content of queue? Nothing, right? Yeah, nothing. Queue dot append 1. So what's the content of queue?
1?
Yes, there's only 1. Queue dot append 2. So what's the content of queue?
10!
1, 2, okay? Let's try again. Queue dot append 3. What's the content of queue?
3!
Yes. Queue dot append left 4, what's the content?
4, 1, 2, 3.
We're done, yes. And then
what?
Q dot append left 5.
5, 4, 1, 2, 3.
Okay, then Q dot pop left. Pop left, and then if I do this X equals Q, what's the content of X?
4, 1, 2, 3.
What's the content of X?
Q dot pop left.
No, what I mean is that Q, X is Q dot pop left. What's the content of Q? What's the content of Q and what's the content of X? If I take a first element out of a Q, what's the left? What are the element left?
Oh, 4, 1, 2, 3.
Okay, Q is 4, 1, 2, 3, and what's X? Which element I took? Which element I took it?
5.
X is 5. Okay, well done. Let's do it again. X dot Q dot pop left. So what's X now?
4.
4, yes. And what's the content of Q?
1, 2, 3.
Yes. Okay, then now let's do this. X dot Q dot pop. Okay, so what's the content of X?
2, 3.
X?
1.
What? Sorry? Pop. Pop. It's not pop left. Pop. What's the difference between pop left and pop?
1, 2.
Q is 1, 2. X is what?
3.
Yes. So do you get it?
Yes.
So your pop is pop to the right, from the right hand side. Pop left is the from left hand side. And push and pop, append left and append. Okay? Got it?
Yes.
Well done today. Good job today.
Good job.
Turn on the lights, please.